Hi there, my name is Dawn and welcome to another installment of my 31 day belly dance makeup vlogging challenge where starting in the month of July 2016, I put on a new and different belly dance makeup face each day, mostly. Anyways, today I have on a look that I'm going to be photographed in a few minutes. I am in the middle of finishing up the last few filling holes in our upcoming book, Becoming a Belly Dancer from Student to Stage. So today I'm going to get into a head-to-toe a suit costume that will represent the ethnographic look. Now, is this an ethnographic makeup job? Not really. But I wanted something that didn't look so heavily tribal. I normally wear very big eyeliner and pretty much go for the gusto. But today I wanted something a little softer, a little lighter, and a little more maybe elegant looking. So here we go. And here is my look for today. I thought I would take a moment to answer a bunch of questions that I've gotten via email, via text, via messages on Facebook and Instagram. So I want to address a few things. Number one is many people have asked me if I was going to start doing costuming tutorials because that seems like the obvious thing for me to do. You write books about costuming, Dawn? Why not costuming tutorials? And I think that's in my future. I need to set up a space where I can make the videos. It's a lighting issue. After we complete Becoming a Belly Dancer from Student to Stage, I'll be doing a slight reorganization of my studio here, and I'll be hanging some ceiling lights above my work table so that I can do some video tutorials in the fall. The second question was, why aren't you telling us what products you're using every day? And so I basically started off with a palette of products and supplies and materials at the beginning of the month. And I've been using basically the same things, and I've gotten into the habit of just saying what's new or what's different. So as soon as I'm finished answering these questions, I will list all the things I've got on my face today, just for you guys who really want to know what products I'm actually using. And last but not least, I've gotten the question of, are you actually going to do 31 challenges? The month is rapidly coming to an end and you're not finished. Well, you know, with the best of intentions, I started on July 1st, but life has come in the way. I was unwell and under the weather for a couple of days this month, and so it became impossible for me to do makeup looks with runny eyes and blowing nose and no voice. So I want to thank you guys for your understanding, and I am going to put together 31 looks. It's just going to run over into August. And so I want to thank you all for your questions. I'm going to get on with the products now. So today I have a variety of products on my face. My mandate for the month was to use drugstore and affordable internet products, things that you can get and have in your kit that you're not afraid to lose or break, that will perform well under stage conditions and can put together something that really does look beautiful, but at a nice price. In the morning after I wash my face, I use a serum. I use the Boots No. 7 Advanced and Protect Serum. It's wonderful. I recommend it for anybody who's over the age of 40. I also use a moisturizer and I put sunscreen on. And the moisturizer and the sunscreen will change based on my needs for the day. Whenever I put on makeup, I put on an extra layer of moisturizer, and I use this really super cheap St. Ives Timeless Skin. You can get this for under $6, and it's a giant tub and it'll last a long time. Is it the best moisturizer in the world? No, but what it does do is it acts as sort of a sub primer for my face and keeps everything moisturized. I do have drier skin. I am over 45. So the next layer is the layer of actual primers. Because I have all of the troubles and trials and problems of aging skin, wrinkles, scars, pigmentation, rough patches, you name it, I've got it. I use a layer of L'Oreal Blur, which is a silicone-based, very thick primer, which I really like. Some people find this greasy, but on my dry skin, this feels perfectly fine. I also use this Boots Number 7 Wrinkle Filler. This, again, is another silicone-based product that I use especially around my underneath my eyes and in this area where I have large pores and around my my laugh lines and crow's feet, just to help kind of act like spackle and fill in. We don't want to think about spackling our faces, but if you are in need of just smoothing out some of the fine lines and wrinkles, I find this product to be wonderful. After that layer, I then put on concealer. Throughout this month, I've been using a variety of different concealers, but my go-to for the last couple of days has been the BH Cosmetics concealer wheel. I did a purchase from BH Cosmetics at the beginning of this to really showcase an affordable brand. I picked them because I really like their eyeshadows and I hadn't really tried this wheel. And as you can see, I've put quite a nice dent into it over the last month of heavy use. What do I like about this? I really like this dark peach under my eyes to help cover up my significant under eye circles. I like this, using this yellow around my mouth. I have some rough spots and I really like to help tone down the red with a little bit of this bright yellow. And then I use the two sort of flesh tone colors to cover up age spots and hyperpigmentation around my face. And so I put this on in a very thin layer before I put on my foundation. And what it does is it helps me save my foundation. This is an affordable product. The foundation's a little more expensive. Today I'm using L'Oreal True Match. My color is N2. And I use two thin layers of this. I'm old school and I use a little disposable wedge sponge that I wash a few times, so I make these last. I figure a bag of this is so much cheaper than a beauty blender and I can make these last for days and days, and then the whole bag lasts for a year. Old school, but still works. Which I let dry for about 10-15 minutes, have a cup of coffee, read some internet. Then I go and I start my color cream product. My eyebrows are my latest discovery from ColourPop, which is this brown and blackish eyebrow pencil. This is a twist up, very fine dark brown color, and it's got a spoolie on the end. This has become my favorite and it's, again, very affordable. On my lower cheeks, I use a cream contour and I use this Revlon Instafix stick, and so this one is called Golden Beige, and I just draw a triangle on here for a very soft, subtle cream contour. I don't like a lot of contouring on my face, but I've discovered in this project that if I go light and if I use creamy products, I really like the effect. That is in this zone here. Above that is, unfortunately, a product that is no longer made, and that's a Maybelline Master Glaze blush. My eyelids today, I use two NYX jumbo crayons. One is Cottage Cheese and the other is in Sparkle Nude. Sparkle Nude is on my eyelid and Cottage Cheese goes from my crease all the way to the top. So this is the bottom half and this is the top half. And that made my creamy base. I always use a cream base underneath my powdered eyeshadows to help them stick. I have very hooded, very deep set eyes, which means my eyelids are always sort of rubbing against each other. So it helps to really nail it down with a good creamy base layer. And so that's what I used today. I used exclusively this Carly Bible palette today from BH Cosmetics. This was one of the things I bought. I've had this for a while. I think it came out last fall. And I bought it for these highlighters, but I used this row of warm colors here on my eyelids today. So you can see I went in with gold and bronze and this deep brown and this highlighter here and here and here, and that is my eye look for today. Let me come in here so you can see what I did. Now this is a little less intense than some of my other belly dance eye looks, but I'm taking pictures today, not going out to dance. If I was going out to dance, I would draw a much thicker, bolder wing on this same eyeshadow. I'm also wearing false eyelashes from the Japanese dollar store. These are from Daiso, and these are number 9. I'm just experimenting with their different eyelash styles, and I really like these. They're very, very spread out, very winged, and because they come from the Japanese dollar store, they only cost $1.50. Why do I call it a dollar store if everything's $1.50? I don't know. But anyways, if you have a Daiso near you, check out the cosmetics section for their eyelashes. It's a great deal. So over the top of my creamy products to set my face, I used some blush and highlights from my Makeup Revolution Sugar and Spice palette, which I got from Ulta. These two shades are over the top. So the lightest shade is here. This slightly darker shade is just below. To set the rest of my face, I used the e.l.f. Illumination palette, which looks like so. It's just to set all of the cream products that were still visible or still open to the air. When I set my makeup for dance, I used a powder puff and the roll pressing technique to really get the powder into my skin. It's an old school theater technique that I learned years and years ago that helps keep your makeup put even if you're sweating. It also gives you a very smooth, flawless finish. Remember, by the time you're done dancing, you are going to want as much of your makeup still on your face as possible. So these old school techniques, you know, are still being used today because they really work. Because I'm doing a photo shoot today, I wanted to have a deeper, richer lip than I would normally wear when I performed. When I perform, I like to wear really bright, really vivid red. I used a combination of this Catrice lip liner in Love the Way You Plum, number 40, and topped that with a Milani creamy lipstick. This is number 67, Matte Confident, and that created the color today. So let me show you how this. So this is a berry colored lip liner with a deep red, sort of a deep bluish red lipstick. And so that's what I wore today to get that lip. Three products I didn't mention. I did use the L'Oreal gel eyeliner today. I also used CoverGirl the Supersizer Mascara. This is just about done. I'm gonna have to open up a new one. What I learned is that basically I will go through a mascara in about 5 months of normal sort of life. But if you're putting on makeup for stage every day, you go through it much. To put on my eyelashes, I use the Duo in green, which is the latex-free version. And I don't know if this is the best latex-free eyelash glue out there, but this is the one that's widely available and it's easy to find in drugstores and at Ulta. And I think that's it. If I need a touch-up or powder throughout the day, I have a L'Oreal True Match powder. It happens to be in my purse right now. And there you have it. That's my look for today. I'm gonna lean in one more time. So if you love these eyes, check out the Carly Bible palette from BH Cosmetics. If you love the lips, try the Milani lipstick in Matte Confident. And if you love the cheeks, I would definitely try that Makeup Revolution Sugar and Spice kit. I have to say, these products have really, really joined my favorites this month. If you enjoyed this video or found it informative or inspiring, please be sure to thumb up and subscribe. There are a couple of more installments left of this vlogging challenge. In the fall, I'm going to be starting a series of costuming tutorials now that I've gotten the hang of making videos with my iPhone 6 and have figured out what I need for lighting and sound and how to edit these videos. I think I'm going to take this project and use it as a springboard for the next one, and I'm going to start putting up a costuming tutorial by popular request and demand. I'll definitely do that. I'm always sewing in my studio, so why not share what's being made on my trusty little Bernina sewing machine, which you can see over my right shoulder back there. So thank you so much. I hope that you have a great day, and I'll see you tomorrow with another belly dance look. Bye.